Hey guys, today is a really exciting day for me because I am starting a reverse diet.
Yes, finally!
So happy about this. I wanted to share this with you because it is constantly a battle for women especially, and I know this happens for men as well, but for females, for you to take time off potentially from losing weight or losing body fat, it can be really what's the word I'm looking for?
Mindfuck.
Daunting experience, yes, or mindfuck if you want to use that word, it's something Layne would say. So today we're gonna go through a little bit of a look over my history, where my macros have been over the last few years, what my training volumes have been like. This is over, I have documents of all of my all of my weights, my macros for the last 2 years. And we're going to see what my intakes are like right now, and then where are good starting places for my macros for this reverse diet. So Layne, do you want to have a quick chat about like the reverse dieting cycle that you're used to seeing, perhaps some common problems that we're seeing with this?
Yeah, I mean, I think you kind of found yourself in it where it's like, you know, being around you for the last year, it's... Well, I have this thing coming up. I got to get ready for it. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, with what you've dealt with your food relationship, your stress response is to eat.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, you would have some success, and then you would overeat, and you would kind of go back to where you were.
Yeah.
And then it was like, okay, well, I want to get more comfortable. I want to get down to this weight. And you would get close, you would get there, and then some stress would come up, and you would go back. And what's happened is over a year, your maintenance calories are like almost down by like 500 compared to where they were. Now you're doing a little bit more activity back then, but I see this a lot with women in particular who keep chasing. I can tell you, your short-term goals are killing your long-term goals.
Success.
They're killing your long-term goals. I just had a client yesterday.
Yeah, I have like five right now.
she did a show. She didn't do as well as she wanted, but she has great potential. She wants to earn a pro card.
Right.
But she said, well, I have the Arnold coming up. Can I diet for that? And we're not even, you know, 3 months into her reverse diet.
Yeah.
What is most important to you? Is looking okay at the Arnold good for you, or is looking fucking amazing on stage and winning your pro card the most important thing to you?
Mm-hmm.
Pro card's the most important thing. Okay, well then either you don't go to the Arnold or you get comfortable with where you're at now. I just got offered a photo shoot. Okay, well, what's more important to you? The photo shoot or winning your pro card?
Yeah.
What is your ultimate goal? Because you have to put that first, and then anything that can chop the legs out from under that, you have to say no.
Yeah.
So we have to keep in mind, like, what is your ultimate goal?
Yeah, and for me right now, I'm not looking, or I didn't necessarily want to do another competition. I was going to do one of September of 2017, November of 2017, just to give me a goal. I wanted to be able to focus on something I enjoy and I love training. So to me, it just made sense. Well, if I'm going to be doing this anyway, I may as well do a show. And obviously there was a lot of stressful things going on in my life and Layne's life at that time, and I just had to give it away. And I made the mistake of not reversing immediately after that. And you'll see when we go through all my data, kind of how my calories have progressively gotten lower and lower because I haven't been able to do this. For me right now, my number one goal is to be able to maintain a comfortable physique. I don't want to look stage ready all the time. I want to have a little bit more body fat, just so that you're not walking around freezing. I want to have good energy levels. But I also don't want to have to do tons of training, and I want good macros. I don't want to have to feel like I'm restricted. And right now, they're comfortable. My numbers are really comfortable, but it's not giving me any flexibility.
If you want a meal out or something, that's going to be all you have.
Yeah, I really have to plan like ahead if I want to go and eat out, and I can do it, no worries. My energy levels are pretty good at the moment, which is great, but it's just not giving me enough leg room to go and eat a donut and a burger. And maybe I want to do that some days, you know?
Yeah. Well, I think the other thing to keep in mind is, again, like, we have clients who will reverse and they'll want to do a mini cut, or they'll want to do, and so many of, they'll go into it, and if you're going to do a fat loss phase, it needs to be focused, targeted, get in, it needs to be like war. Go in, dominate, and get out, okay?
Yeah.
That's how fat loss phases need to be done. Now, I'm not saying do it short, but what I'm saying is when you're there, you are there, you are intense, you are focused, you're gonna get it done, get to where you want, and then you're gonna get out of that deficit in the appropriate way so that you can move forward. If you fuck around with these little mini cuts like most people, and in particular women do, where it's, well, I've got this thing I wanna be ready for, you know, I'd like to look good for this wedding, or we're going to Cabo, or it's Tuesday, or it's fucking February, or just pick anything. Anything will come up.
I know, and I'm a sucker for this. I just did that. We had the Arnolds, and we were going to be at a booth, and obviously we want to kind of portray the coaching style that we offer. So yeah, I was like, oh, I probably should be in a little bit better shape for the Arnolds. And it's also my birthday. Everyone wants to look good for their birthday, but
please. Oh, look good for my birthday.
Who cares, really, in the sense of things. So. I have been a hypocrite of this as well.
It's easy to get, so it's the Arnolds, and then it's, oh, we're going to Thailand in April. Oh, we've got a seminar in May.
Yeah.
Oh, well, then it's summer. You know, like, it's focus.
Yeah.
Don't let what you want right now supersede what you want most.
Yeah, think of the big picture. So right now for me, I'm going to be really trying to get my calories up. I want to be part of the 300 carb club right now. And I would also really like to get my fats to about 80 and be at a comfortable weight at that as well. So we're going to go through how we're going to plan this out and what my starting reverse macros are.
What are your macros right now?
Right now, my macros are 145 protein, which is actually a lot lower than I usually am, as you'll see in the data. My carbohydrates are 135. Yeah, you said it. And 40 grams of fat, which is really low. So I'm on 1485.
I had that for my pre-bed meal last night.
Yeah, I know. Literally, he went to bed last night and was eating what I would eat for my entire day. I was like, can you feel the laser beams going through your skull? Yeah. From burns. The other room.
Burns.
So yeah, let's go take a look, and hopefully you can relate some of this information to your own personal circumstances and don't fall into this repeat cycle behavior where you're dieting, oh, there's something else. So let's go to it.
So what are we looking at here?
Okay, so this is my dieting history for the last 2 years. I started my macros right about here. So June, I wanted to do a long, slow prep, an 18-week contest prep. So this is where I started at.
So 2000 was the highest you ever got.
Yeah, last year.
You didn't really lose weight on these initial macros though.
No, it's because if you look here to the compliance column, I was not compliant for some of these weeks. So some of these weeks during here, my weight went from like 68 to 69, 68 up to 71 here. These were non-compliant weeks. See, this is a no. So I would have binged on this week because of some kind of crazy stress in my weight's blown up. So it would have been a lot higher than this.
Yeah, that was those 1,463 calories right here. Mm-hmm. And you were down by, I mean, basically down by 2 kilos
the beginning. The lightest I got was 65 kilos, and that was the week before I ended up having to quit the show.
And that's only about 2.8 kilos down, so you really didn't lose that much weight for
I didn't, and that's because there were so many non-compliant weeks in here.
And what do you think your stage weight would have been, 62?
62 kilos was my estimated stage weight at about 7%, 8% body fat.
Okay. So then I think here's the real problem. So you just went into maintenance mode at about 1,700 calories.
Yeah, exactly. And yeah, so I did.
Is this right here, 62 kilos?
Oh, no, that's incorrect. Sorry, I'm not sure what that is. It's a typo. But
maybe 67.
Yeah, from October when I quit the show all the way through to December here, I was just doing maintenance. I didn't really want to try and, I didn't want to gain any weight, that's for sure, because I was kind of unhappy with
my physique. Gained about 1.5 kilos, but I mean, that was mostly in the first week from non-compliance.
Yeah, exactly. So when I came out of the show, I definitely was super stressed around this period of time. We had a lot going on. So I was non-compliant. So yeah, my weight got up to about 70. Yeah, so I wanted to do
68.8 kilos here.
Yeah, 69 was the heaviest I got to. So yeah, that's when I started fat loss for the Arnolds.
And you got down to 66.6.
Yeah, well, my lowest was 66.2.
So you lost 2.4 kilos. You did have to take your, I mean, you started at 1700, went down to 1430. But you can already see the difference. Like if you're up here, you started at 2000, got down to 66.7. right? So you lost almost 3 kilos there.
Yeah.
Here you only lost less than 2 kilos. Or no, you lost 2 kilos here, 2.5 kilos.
Yeah.
But you had to go all the way down to 1,400. Yeah. In both cases, you dropped about 300 calories to lose that weight. Mm-hmm. But in this case, your starting point was so much lower than previous that now you end up in a worse spot. Yeah. So you're always going to have some metabolic adaptation when you diet, right? And I talk about this in the book we just released, Peter and I just released the Complete Contest Prep Guide, that you're always going to have probably about the same percentage. So you're always going to deal with that calorie drop.
Yeah.
But if we could start you out at, like, that's about 15% metabolic adaptation we're looking at there.
Yeah.
And obviously, like, we're dealing with non-compliance and some other things, so it's hard to say exactly how much it was. But if we could start you out at 3,000 calories, now that 300 calorie drop is to 2,700.
Yeah, which is so much more achievable.
Or even if it was 2,500, or even if it was double, 20, and you had a 600 calorie adaptation,
yeah.
Now it's 2,400 that you end up at, as opposed to whatever. Now, I don't know if we can get you to 3,000, you know, but if we could get you to 2,500, you're still in a better position.
So if I wanted to get to, say, 300 carbohydrates and I wanted to get to 75 and 165 protein, that puts me at around 2,500 calories, which I think is a really great starting point for me.
Yeah.
Right now,
3,000 is too much.
That is 1,000 calories more than what I'm even on. So I cannot expect to get there overnight. So we need to kind of go through exactly what we're going to do for my starting reverse diet. So that is the ultimate end point.
I think looking at how quickly I usually like to go, if we're going to be, do you want a conservative reverse?
Yeah, and that's one of my concerns. I don't want to be I don't want to get over 69 kilos ever again. So my goal for this reverse diet is to maintain within a 3 kilo buffer. That's as much as I'm happy to actually put on during this reverse, otherwise I'm just a miserable.
Well, if we target an increase of 1,000 calories, we're looking at about 40 calorie a week increase.
Okay.
Assuming that it goes like how, now some weeks we may be able to do more, some weeks we do less.
Yeah.
But I think starting with, you know, now do you want an initial calorie boost, or are you going to be super
conservative? No, I'll be super conservative. As I said, I don't want to.
But could we do like a 60 calorie boost for the beginning? Because that's a pretty, you're not going to be above maintenance with that.
Yeah, no, that's fine. So if we stay, I think I would like to increase my protein because that is, the macros at 145 right now are really difficult for me to adhere to because I just, my habits are protein containing food. So we'll take that up. If we go to 150 carbs and
Well, that's already 70 or 80 calories, which is fine. I think you could go up 100 calories even. So that's what you're doing. Like, I think 100 calories is a good starting point if you want to be conservative.
All right.
I think you can even go up to 45 grams of fat and be safe.
45?
Or did you want to do 50?
Well, what's this? So I'm finishing on 1459 and I'm going to come up to 1581. So that is over 100 calories right there.
I think we could start there. That's going to give you some more flexibility, a little bit, not much. But
let's go 145. Yeah, that's exactly 100 calories.
Great. Satisfies your OCD.
It does.
Okay. All right, well then let's start there.
Okay.
As long as you know that, you know, this is, so one thing I like to point out is it's okay to be more aggressive if you're willing to accommodate some more fat gain if you need that flexibility. But if you think that those are realistic numbers for you to be able to hit for another week, then.
Well, like I said, I think the numbers that I'm on are not, I'm not hungry from them. I still have plenty of energy, and if I plan ahead, it's super easy. It's just my drawback is stress, and the stress response for me at the moment is overeating, and that's what caused me to have this problem. So if I can just get through this week, which I think will be fine, and then next week it's only going to continue to get better.
Yeah, get you some wins.
Mm-hmm.
Cool, so we're starting at 150, 145, 45. So I guess we'll just update each week and see how things go.
Okay. So I've been needing to have a in-body scan, though they are not 100% accurate. That test result came back at 8.7% body fat. Now, I know that that is a little over the top. Now, if I had skin folds or something done like that, Perhaps my body fat percentage might be a little bit higher, around the 10 or 11%, which is my estimate. So I am going to have a repeat test done on the same machine under the same conditions, just to see how similar my body fat percentages and my body composition is at the end of this reverse. But to finish my fat loss diet, and it was just a very short 8-week fat loss diet, I managed to lose 3 kilos during that period of time. So I started the fat loss diet at about 69 kilos and I got down to 66.2 or 5 or something like that. I jumped on the scales this morning and my weight is 66.5. So starting my reverse from here, my end of fat loss diet macros were 145 protein, 135 carbohydrate, which was a bit of a stretch for me. It was kind of challenging, but manageable, and 40 grams of fat. So that is where I finished. My goal is to get up to around 300 grams of carbohydrates if I can push my metabolism to those kind of lengths, and around 75 grams of fat. So I'm very excited for the increase in calories, and during this reverse diet, my plan is not to gain too much weight. I don't really want to be heavier than 68 kilos because that is where I am most comfortable. I feel really happy and I still have heaps of confidence, plenty of energy. So that is the long-term goal for this. So I'm going to do a quick physique check with you guys so you can see exactly what I look like to begin with. And then we'll see how I go over the next 8 weeks of increasing food. Yeah. Sorry if it's hard to catch my vibe. I need a lover to trust, tell me you're on my side. Are you down for the ride? It's not easy for someone to catch my eye. But I've been waiting for you for my whole damn life, my whole.